special show, Reality of Realty. Protecting and nurturing your property investment is in the best interest of not just the developer, but of the buyer as well. The buyer and developer relationship over the years has suffered due to negative sentiments, and now it's time for the two stakeholders to work together instead of working against each other. In this episode, we offer a step-by-step guide to seeking resolution to your problems by engaging with the developer in a non-adversarial manner. We advise the buyer when is the right time to engage in negotiation and when is the right time to escalate the issue. We have a brilliant panel here with us. We have with us Dr. Niranjan Hiranandani. He's founder and managing director, Hiranandani Group, and also president, NAREDCO, and vice president, ASSOCHAM. We also have with us Mr. Samantha Das. He is the executive director and chief economist, research and real estate intelligence services of JLL India. And joining us is Mr. Gagan Randev. He is national director, capital markets and investment services, Colliers International India, and also Mr. Sarvesh Tiwari. He's an infrastructure expert. Welcome, gentlemen, all of you. Dr. Hiranandani, I'd like to begin with you. You've spent years in this industry. You've seen everything, all the ups and downs. How do you think that the buyer, what are the common mistakes that he makes that he ends up damaging his own property and is his own investment?
I think most of the time the person takes a lot of effort in order to make his buy for his clothes, his shoes and his other things, but he doesn't pay enough attention for the purposes of buying his house. Some verification which will take place for the purposes of buying his house would be extremely useful. Today it's very easy. You look up the RERA website, check up the numbers, get full data on the whole thing, and most of the questions will be answered about the legality of the project, the dimensions, the carpet area, the period in which the building will be given, the installments, everything is going to be available. So a little due diligence and research before buying a house would be extremely useful. Second, I would look forward to check whether the developer himself has done a good job in the previous projects that he has done. It's not very difficult to find out. A visit to one of them would give you an idea as to what is the quality of the work, what is the kind of thing. It's so easy to do. You go and visit several projects for the purpose of buying your house. A good visit to one of his previous projects would make a world of a difference. The third important thing would be to see if you can check the titles to the property, which is always attached to the draft documents which are given. If you can have a reading through them, you will get a full idea of the title. Today, it is imperative for the developer to give all these details on the project. I think if you do all this, it will go a long way in order to make sure that you don't go on the wrong path.
That's true. As I say, prevention is always better than cure. Always be careful in the beginning. But Gagan, what would you suggest to the buyers? What should be the right way to go ahead with it?
So I'll just step a little back and give you a little bit of context. So what Mr. Hiranandani said is absolutely the right way of going about it in future. On the third point, which is the checking the legal docs, etc., I don't think individuals possibly have the expertise or the knowledge. So a good check, counter check would be if banks have are lending on a home loan, etc., because they do the due diligence before they sanction home loans. But everything else, I agree with them.
But what about people are investing in commercial property? Then that time they should look at it.
Absolutely, yes. Absolutely. So coming to the question that you said about, okay, I made an investment and it doesn't turn out to be the proper one. And in most cases it's happening today, because till a couple of years back, when property was only going one way, which is you bought today and it was a question of whether it was going to be 10% up or 20% off, 30% off, it never hurt you. I think in the last couple of years, when property prices have been at a standstill, and if you look at inflated adjusted returns, you are actually looking at negatives. That is when it is a double hurt. So if you bought a property and you're stuck with it, I think it's important to understand, why are you stuck with the property? One, was there some wrong intentions of the developer where they used the money and bought other land, which is typically the problem which happened with 60-70% of the developers, especially in
NCR.
In NCR. So a lot of the brickbats the developers faced earlier were legitimate because they diverted money. But I think for people who've been trying to clean up in the last couple of years, they're also, facing challenges which are not really totally within their span of control.
Right. Mr. Das, what about you? Do you think, because for an individual investor, especially the one investing in a commercial property, we did have very unrealistic, expectations from our investments. Do you think over the years it's settled down now and the buyer is also a little bit more open to negotiation with developer now?
My first and foremost, thing that I want to actually talk about is you're saying about investment, individual investment in commercial. Let's understand, if you see the trajectory of commercial real estate, I think it's moving from strength to strength. And if you see the structure of the entire negotiation, both the buyers and sellers are more or less equally strong. The first and foremost point, the pain point between the buyer and seller relationship is in residential. So as Mr. Hiranandani was talking about and Gagan also talked about, RERA has a big role to play. And Mr. Hiranandani raised a very pertinent question that the data information that is disseminated to the rest of the world, a buyer can really make a good due diligence. But the first question is, yes, in MahaRERA I agree totally, because I think that's a leading state in terms of RERA implementation and data uploading as well as pertinent data. But if you go to rest of the states, I think the implementation of RERA needs to be really stronger to give that opportunity for buyers to really dig into or probe into before buying a property. Definitely this era, I'm very confident that this relationship between buyer and seller, the environment is being created.
Right.
So, going forward, I think this will also become very strong and it will be looked upon as a joint venture.
All right. Suresh, what do you think, as he's saying it would be looked upon as a joint venture, how do you think that the customers can look at it like that and think of creating a long-term asset value to whatever they buy, and work towards it?
It has to be like that, Anjali. See what Hiranandani Saab and Gagan said. I think that is the initial stage which they are talking about. Now, there's a very big stages between you buy a property and you own it. But during that course, I have been seeing this.
Relationship goes through ups and downs.
Yes, and that is the problem. So, with the advent of social media, everybody is a journalist and this pocket phones are doing magic for them. They feel that they are doing something good for the industry. But in a long run, what they are doing is they are just hitting their own property. Because if you talk negative about the industry continuously, what happens is the value of your own property goes down. So I always say that failure calls for polishing, not for demolition. If you know that something wrong is happening, your first thing is to interact with the builder. Go straight and talk. There are norms which are supporting you. You have become more powerful than earlier.
Right.
The carpet areas are defined now. There were ambiguities earlier, which is not now. And then the RERA website tells you everything.
Right.
So I think that the buyers are more powerful now, but they are using the tools which should not be used because the industry is going down because of their initiatives.
Right, that's true. There's a lot of transparency now. Well, we're going to continue this conversation on the other side, but it's time for a short break now. Welcome back. We're talking about how to protect and nurture your investment. Dr. Hiranandani, we've been talking about the fact that buyers should think about negotiation or renegotiation if required, but are the developers ready to negotiate with the investor? And also, what would you suggest? What would your tips be to the buyer who is thinking about it and is planning to go onto the table?
Surprisingly, you will find that a large number of people are now negotiating, at least in Mumbai and Maharashtra. Even those who have complaints in Vera, they have again referred to conciliation committees, and I sit on one of the conciliation committees also. And those matters which are referred to conciliation, 80% have been solved just by negotiation and discussion. So it is possible to negotiate and do. I'm not saying it's possible in all cases. It's definitely there that there are certain projects which are beyond redemption, and there are certain customers who are actually litigious minded. But leave aside the 20% of those extremes, you do find that a large number of builders, a large number of customers are ready to sit on the negotiation table and come to a conclusion with us. We find that happening very, very well in our RERA conciliation committee. But look at the other aspect of it. The cost of delay in terms of litigation is so expensive and so difficult because the customer puts in all his money into the property. Look at it from the point of developer. If he has 20, 30, 40 such litigations, the whole projects will come to a standstill. So I think on a compromise basis, it is good both for the developer and for the customer to really sit down on the table and try and negotiate and do it. Not going to get conclusive in all the cases, but a large number of cases today are getting concluded in this manner.
Right, Mr. Das, as Mr. Hiranandani is saying, the two stakeholders are right now at the two extreme ends of the spectrum. Now, if we look at the current legal proceedings that are going on, and when we look at it, are there any lessons that we can learn from them?
I think I was about to talk regarding the conciliation platform. I think it's a great, great platform, which Mr. Hiranandani said, and negotiation under the umbrella of RERA on this conciliation platform is the solution today, because we also find that the majority of the problems are sorted out on this conciliation forum or platform, whatever you call it. So that's the way out now and way forward. And I think most of the state RERA should also follow suit. I mean, there is nothing wrong in following a model RERA, and which will actually make the relationship between buyer and seller very healthy.
Then, do you think still real estate can be a good investment? Because a lot of people get scared when they see all these things in the newspapers and television sets.
I think honestly, and I was a bear on residential prices for a long time. I think there is no better time than today. And if you understand the market today, which actually is not great news for a large number of developers, but let's assume the market 3 years back was 100. Today that market of 100 being the new units being sold, that 100 is down to 50. But earlier that 100 used to be comprised of 100 developers. Today that 100 is down to 20. So the better developers who have a track record of delivery, who have come out with great products where customers are happy, etc., and typically track to reality, for instance, lists out in 2019 also, they listed out the top developers in the country in terms of customer satisfaction, etc., they are gaining an inordinate amount of market share. So as a residential buyer, if your idea is to buy it for your own consumption or for your children, etc., there is no better time.
Dr. Hiranandani, I'm trying to find out, there was a time when developers used to make some promises and came up with schemes which were difficult to understand for even the buyer. Is that age over? Are developers more honest about returns now?
I think they are totally honest and brutally honest, especially after the RERA incoming. I don't see any developer trying to make any statement or promises which he cannot honor or keep. The future is not hard to see, que sera, sera, whatever will be. But the fact is that they are able to tell you exactly what they are going to construct, what is the title to the property, what is the time frame in which you are going to do it, and what is the price of the property at the time of committing it to the buyer. I don't think anybody is trying to predict the future, at least not on paper and not even otherwise. I don't think anybody can afford to do so in the RERA scenario. And if he does, then he is going to be caught on that situation, because any such statements made can be brought to the RERA authorities, and the person can be held accountable for the purposes of doing so. So this is not going to happen, and it's certainly not happening. I don't see it happening at all in the future. Yes, it has happened in the past. People have made broad statements, and many of them have come true, because the markets really were extremely bullish for many, many, many years.
Right.
But today that is, situation has changed, and I don't think this is going to continue in the future. But bull runs will be following. From bear runs to bull runs will happen.
Hmm.
And people will see things improving in sectors. Not in all the sectors, not in all, similar to what happens in the stock market. Not all companies will do well,
right.
Not all companies in a particular sector will do well. I think in the real estate scenario, you're going to follow the same principle. Not all projects will do well, either residential or commercial. Not all companies will do well all the time is what is going to happen in the future. So now the study will really be for the investors to pick and choose the right item they want to invest, and it will be just like anybody investing into the stock market. Not a surety 100%, but the direction can be known from people who are good analysts, and good investors will certainly continue to make a lot of money in the real estate field.
So choose wisely is what you say, Sarvesh. Do you think you agree with that? Choose wisely, stay invested, and also because the market, as everyone on the panel was saying, now it's easier to choose the right person also, because the bad lot has been weeded out.
Yes, you are more safe now. And I request even the Credai and other forums, they should also do scrutiny to find out who are bad in their fraternity. And they should also start avoiding those people. It's not only the buyers.
To a certain extent.
So they should be more strict on that, A. B, when we are talking about commercial investment, I feel that there are certain things which are going very good. Like MOX, if you see Mobile Open Exchange Zone, which have been created by with the support of government, where you can do the research and you can even produce the product. And that is happening in Greater Noida and other places where the state government is giving so much benefits on GST and other things. Even REIT, which we were talking about, I am expecting so much investment coming from foreign in office spaces and other areas. So I believe, as Gavin was saying, that commercial versus residential, so I think both are going hand in hand, and it's good time to invest. Yes, it's very good time to invest.
So I'm winding up now, but quickly I would request each of you for one phrase, and if you could advise our buyers and investors. Mr. Das, if we could begin with you.
Yeah. For the buyers, of course, be very careful about selecting the developer and projects, and don't expect the growth, the returns to be as used to happen earlier. Let's not really hope for doubling of residential price in 3-4 years, which is history now. We will see much sustainable growth, and
right,
you know, with minimization of risk, with reduction of risk, please reduce your expectation also on returns.
So be careful and be practical. Mr. Hiranandani?
A lot more homework requires to be done, but you can always use the financial institutions which give home loans. Go to them and find out everything about the developer and the projects. They have all this information on the fingertips, and they can definitely guide you as to which are the projects which are approved, which are sound, and which developers are sound. Mostly they will give you a direction in the right way to tell you buy this and don't go to this project or developer, because the past experience of those financial institutions have been negative.
Right. So take help from experts, I would say. What about you, Gavin?
Just one word, make informed choices. But along with that, just make sure the infrastructure is there today and don't get too futuristic about the infrastructure.
Right. What about you, sir?
I say don't devalue your own property by going into social media and other platform. So meet and resolve with the builders. That is the solution.
So we're going to wind up this show with all these important tips that we've given you. Now, if you are a first-time buyer or are already invested, these are some things that you should remember and work by. Thank you for watching.